sorry, Judy. I feel so ashamed. He should never have said those terrible things.
Oh, heck. I've been called worse than that in my time, believe me.
I've tried to teach them manners, but it's no use. The kids they mix with around here are all just as bad. It's no wonder a lot of them turn out wild living in a do-it-yourself slum like this.
Oh, come on, they're not all bad. I mean, what about Russell?
It'll get to him eventually, too. There's no way out of it.
I think you're letting it get you down, kid. I think you need to get away from those kids sometime.
Well, I do go out sometimes when they're at school, but all I end up doing is walking around the same streets, looking in the same shop windows at things I can't afford to buy.
Why don't you start coming over to Driscoll House, you know? We could continue our course on cooking, and we could swap jobs with some of the women. You do their work, and they do babysitting for you.
I'd hate to let Gary loose on anyone.
I'd match some of my women against him, don't worry. Well, what do you think?
Well, it'd be worth a try, I suppose.
Good. Now, how about this delectable meal? I'm starving.
G'day, Bea. How are you, love?
Well, she can't be too bad, Lizzie. I just found her helping Daniels mop the floor in the corridor.
Is Maxine all right, then?
Well, why shouldn't she be?
I told you this morning, Mrs. M, she was feeling a bit croak.
Yeah, well, she's recovering, and I'll keep an eye on her.
You have enough to do looking after yourself, Bea.
Don't worry about me, Mrs. M. I mend real quick. You have to in this joint.
All the same, I think you should stay off the press for a few days. Why don't you try the sewing machine? Okay, ladies, back to work.
You didn't do quite as good a job on Maxine as you did on me, did you, Mackenzie? I was a bit pushed for time. Our lady of the press here, our dope-pushing fiend, bashed Maxine this morning simply because she happens to be a friend of Lizzie's. And Lizzie upset our dope-pusher because she dug up her supplies and flushed them down the can.
What'd you do that for, Lizzie?
Because I'm fed up with seeing you dopey-eyed looking lot lolling around the place and running the risk of getting us all into trouble.
Well, it was a fat waste of time, Wrinkles, because the supplies will keep coming in. And just to prove my point, see this little card here? There are quite a few happy tickets on it. LSD trips dropped on with an eyedropper.
Do you mean to tell me I've got that filthy muck up on the wall next to St. Peter and the Nativity?
They're going at a reasonable rate, ladies. Any buyers?
Anyone who does can forget about any protection from me. From now on, you'll be on your own.
There'll always be someone who wants to buy a ticket out of here for a while, at any price.
My fault. I naturally assumed you'd be having lunch here.
Yes, I would have, but it turned out that they fed us on the flight.
Oh, well, probably would have been too late anyway. Maybe we can have dinner tonight.
Oh, not tonight, I'm afraid. I have a dinner engagement with Colonel Matthews. You remember Matthews? Bevan Matthews?
No, I don't think I do.
Oh, no, of course you wouldn't. It's catching up with Bevan that's my main reason for the visit. Naturally, it's a good opportunity to see you again, too.
Where's your luggage?
I left it at the motel.
But I thought you'd be staying here.
Well, I didn't know what your setup was. I wasn't sure if there'd be room.
Yeah. Well, not to worry. Maybe we can have dinner tomorrow night.
Yes, I've kept it free for just that purpose. Where's Haddo?
I lost him.
Run away?
No, he died. I miss him. He was the only friend I had.
Yes. Must be difficult making friends in a new city, I suppose.
I don't really need them. I get along quite well on my own.
How are you settling into the job?
Oh, very well. As a matter of fact, the governor's position has just become available. Naturally, I've applied for it. And it seems likely that I'll get it.
Sounds as though you're getting back into your stride again.
Oh, I've organised a tour of the prison for you this afternoon. You will be able to make it, won't you?
Well, I don't see why not. I had nothing definite planned. And it could be an interesting experience.
I was wondering if it was all right with you if I Made a little bit of pocket money on the side. Well, nothing drastic. You know, sort of 20 cents for palm reading and tarot cards and 10 cents for teacup reading and things like that.
Oh, yeah, why not? If they're stupid enough to throw away their money, help yourself.
Well, it's not our fate, you know. I do have some powers. Mm. It's just that some people expect a big show for their money. That's how I come to being here.
Are you trying to tell me you really are a medium?
Oh, yes. Ever since I was a little girl. But it's not enough for people paying big money. They expect a show with all the trimmings.
Oh, hello, Lainey. How was Alan?
Oh, he's okay.
You don't seem very excited about him.
Oh, it's just that he got a job up in the country picking fruit. I'm not going to see him for a while.
Cheer up, love. At least he's got a job.
Yeah. Thanks, Lizzie. Hey, Babs. How's it going?
Terrific. Everything seems so different. I never realized the material in these sheets is so beautiful.
God, you've done it.
Oh, I thought we agreed to do it later tonight. I couldn't wait. Anyway, it's making work a whole lot better.
Where are you going?
To the toilet.
You only just got back.
Yeah.
Stupid little bitch. I told you to wait until you were back in your cell.
Don't get mad. I'll behave myself, I promise.
You really are a mongrel, aren't you, Mackenzie? Now you just lay off her until she comes out of it.
Back to wet nursing, eh, Smith? We make a fine pair, don't we? I dope them up and you look after them.
Where's Lainey?
She said she was going to the dunny.
Oh, charming. Now we'll have another one of them on our hands.
Oh, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
This is Mrs. Morris. Mrs. Morris, my father, Major Ferguson.
How do you do, Major?
How do you do?
Hope you enjoy your tour.
I'm sure I will. It all sounds very interesting.
Well, everything under control?
Oh, yes, yes. We managed to muddle through.
Good. Well, Father, if you'll just sign the visitor's book, I'll take you through to the acting governor.
Of course. Yeah. We'll see you later, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, of course, Major.
Oh, hi.
Feeling good?
Well, keep me a seat on the rainbow bus because I'm hopping off.
Oh, go on, Sarah. Just for fun. I've never been to a seance before.
Oh, no. It's not the kind of thing you fool around with, you know.
Oh, we wouldn't be fooling around. We'd do it for real. Couldn't you call down a spirit to haunt the freak?
Hey, yeah. How about Jack the Ripper?
Oh, God, not Jack the Ripper.
Now, listen. Faking a seance for a customer, that's one thing. But playing around with it for real, it can be very, very dangerous.
Oh, we take it very seriously. Wouldn't we, girls?
Oh, you're honest. But you become too involved. I mean, it stops you making decisions. You can't live life without consulting the spirit world for guidance. It becomes like a drug.
Really? How'd you like to go on a commission? 20 cents for a friend, 50 cents for a relative, and a dollar for a night with Elvis.
Right, attention, everyone. The acting governor will be here in a moment with a VIP guest who is making a tour of the prison. Now, you will all behave in a civil manner and speak only when spoken to. And there will be no smoking while the Major is here, understand that?
Did you say Major, Miss Ferguson?
That's right, Birdsworth. Major. And you will address him, if you must, by that rank.
Is he a Salvation Army Major?
No, Birdsworth, he is not.
Well, this is the laundry section.
Good afternoon, ladies.
Oh, I thought you were a Salvation Army Major.
Birdsworth.
Oh, sorry, Major.
That's quite all right, Miss... Mrs...
Birdsworth. Elizabeth Birdsworth.
No, actually, I'm a retired Army Major, Mrs. Birdsworth. One of the boys in khaki.
Oh, Lizzie's one of our long-termers. She's almost part of the place.
Oh, I take it then that you're in charge of the laundry.
No, they wouldn't put me in charge of a chicken coop. Not that I blame them. This is B. Smith. She's in charge.
Smith?
Oh, how do you do, Major?
Well, don't let me stop you at your work. I am quite sure that you're very anxious to get back to it.
Excuse me, Mrs. Powell. I think they might be ready for us in the dining room now.
All right, Major Ferguson.
Goodbye, ladies. And thank you for your time.
Bye. Bye.